Hey YouTube and knife fans, so let's take a look at all of them again now that have been upgraded, modified, etc. etc. Haven't modified all of them, but well, I've done a few, so we'll take a look. So, starting in 1982 was First Blood. Knife was created by Jimmy Lyle. He created 6 knives for the movie. Each knife had 14 teeth and a unique clip grind. So I've modified my Hollywood Collectible Group First Blood knife to replicate that. What was interesting is knives from 14 to 100 only had 12 teeth, and their clip grinds varied from a clip grind very similar to the movie knife right through to just a standard shallow grind that just followed the profile of the blade. The knife number 50 was sold to the president of United Cutlery, and he was given permission to replicate that knife, which he did. So the United Cutlery knife is an exact replica of knife number 50, and that's why I've kept it to this day. It comes with a ordinary looking leather sheath, not a bad feeling sheath. It's just not movie accurate or anything close. It's brown, I suppose. It's as close as it gets. It's a right-hander. It's got a retaining strap. And the knife itself is... it's got an epoxy handle, aluminium handle on it with epoxy. So don't use it. It's a wall hanger. Hollywood Collectible has the threaded construction, threaded rod construction, stainless steel tube handle, and these blades are actually hard. So when I did the mod, the grind, you can't file this. I had to use the belt sander because yeah, you couldn't file this. It was hard. So that made this mod a little tricky, but it worked out okay. And then I've remasked, repainted, and also dyed the handle darker. Sheath by 15 sheaths or knives, and he's made an exceptional replica of the movie screen sheath. It's a lefty, like the movie, and he's even got the colour pretty close, so very happy with that one. Then in 1985 we had Rambo First Blood Part 2, and the Mission Knife. So this is also a Hollywood Collectible version. The only thing I've done to mod this one is paint the end cap black, because for some reason they're all silver. The sheath is another 15 knives sheath, with a genuine 1980s diamonds hone in the front. Easy lap. Blade itself is pretty much identical to all the replicas out there. Oops, can't see that. 14 teeth, full flat grind. This one does have a stainless steel handle, 30 rod construction. Like all the First Blood knives, it has the screwdrivers top and bottom. Phillips head up here and a flat blade down the bottom. This one's got the 10 inch blade, 2 inch wide, where the First Blood was 9 inch by 1.5 inch. Rambo First Blood Part 2 is also finished in a black finish with the silver edging as opposed to the grey. So this one is another left-hand side sheath with the really long strap on the retainer, and I just added the leather cords, the leg strap, and the one that goes on the end of the pommel. Moving on to Rambo 3 in 1988, I have not modified this knife. The only thing I really think that needs to be done is darken the sheath. It's not much unless I replace the sheath. There's not a lot I can do with this one because it's got that big embossing in the front. The knife is quite nice. It's United Cutlery. With the Gilhuben stamp. These were licensed by Gilhuben. It's a hollow grind as opposed to the flat grinds from the other two. No saw teeth. And it's just a beast of a knife. Great design. And I really can't see any need to modify this one. I've maybe changed the cord. I've put a shoelace on there, which I've had in there since 1989, I think. So the only thing I would, that'd be the only mod I'd do to this knife, and then of course the sheath. Then we had a massive break from the Rambo trilogy, saga. Became a saga after the first three, with this beast of a thing. Again, original knife was made by Gilhuben. This is the knife he forges before rescuing the missionaries. So all I've done to this one is I've cut the end of the scabbard off to expose the blade tip, like the movie accurate version, and I've added a press stud to the top, and I've just darkened it. It looks black here, but it's not. It's actually dark brown. This is a Hibben 4 replica. 1095 high carbon steel, I think. Big heavy beast of a thing. Then in 2019 we got the Pulforce collection. So these are both Hollywood collectible replicas. This one's a limited number edition. This is not. I have not modified the MK8 in any way, but the MK9 has been bead blasted and had the scale scales color changed, so that looks closer to the actual knife. Again, the sheath has the embossing. I wish I'd just stick that on the back instead of the front. It's not a bad sheath, but it's not quite the right shape to be movie accurate, so that will have to be replaced at some point. These blades are normally painted, and I decided to bead blast it because I think it looks it's better, comes out nicer with that lighter grey satin finish. I also bead blasted the guard and the shroud. And the handle scales, which are injection molded plastic on this one, has been just painted with a vinyl car paint. The MK8 has not been modified. It's probably a bit dark, so at some point we'll bead blast that one as well. So that pretty much wraps up the five movies and the six main knives. Hope it was interesting. And it's a bit of an update really from where I was in the last video that I did on the five Rambo knives, or six Rambo knives, where I was still using the United Cutlery versions, and I hadn't modified four, or I don't even think I'd modified five. So, bit of an update. Thanks for watching, we'll catch you in the next one.